Welcome to Biodiesel Magazine's top stories for late July. I'm your host, Jacob Noderman. Before we get started, I'd like to thank this edition's headline sponsor, Christensen's Biofuels Financial Conference. The event, scheduled for September 27th and 28th in Minneapolis, aims to help those in the ethanol and biodiesel industries make the best use of capital and resources. Attendees will learn how to create a well-managed plan for growth and change that maximizes profitability while ensuring future stability. The conference is produced by Christensen PLLP and organized by BBI International. Visit biofuelsfinancialconference.com for more information. U.S. Representatives Diane Black of Tennessee and Ron Kind of Wisconsin introduced legislation last week to extend the biodiesel blender's tax credit and phase the incentive out by 2022. Under the proposed phase-out, the value for the blender's tax credit would be $1 per gallon in 2017 and 2018, 75 cents in 2019, and 50 cents in 2020 and 2021, after which the incentive would sunset. The National Biodiesel Board said the incentive would provide greater benefits as a domestic producer's versus a blender's credit, while other associations representing foreign producers, importers, petroleum, retail, and trucking organizations applaud the proposal. U.S. President Donald J. Trump has nominated American Soybean Association CEO Steve Sensky to serve as Deputy Secretary of Agriculture at USDA. Sensky has led the soybean group as CEO since 1996. Sensky served at USDA more than 20 years ago in the Reagan and George H.W. Bush administrations, including as Administrator of the Foreign Agricultural Service. Given the U.S. biodiesel industry's roots in the ASA, biodiesel proponents are hopeful Sensky will be a strong advocate for biodiesel in the Trump administration. The U.S. EPA has announced plans to hold a public hearing August 1st in Washington, D.C. for its recently released proposal to set 2018 renewable volume obligations under the Renewable Fuel Standard, along with the 2019 RVO for biomass-based diesel. The EPA said the hearing aims to provide interested parties the opportunity to present data, views, or arguments concerning the proposal. Those wishing to testify at the hearing should notify the EPA by July 25th. After 18 months of testing, microalgae manufacturer EcoDuna has selected Schatz glass tubes for a new photobioreactor site in Vienna, Austria. The facility will be Europe's largest plant dedicated to the harvest of omega-3 fatty acids from microorganisms. Schott will deliver several hundred thousand units that can hold more than 780,000 liters of photoactive volume. In all, the facility will produce 100 tons of algae annually. Eparella, a subsidiary of EcoDuna, will operate the substantial 2.5-acre plant. It is scheduled to be built this year using 143 miles of glass tubing. Production will start in 2018. To view these stories in their entirety or for more news, features, or data from the most respected and viewed biodiesel site in the world, visit biodieselmagazine.com. See you next time.